Today, at this learning, as we go on, and today my topic, as you can see here, like how many of you feel that the creativity and innovation is missing. You all are working on day-to-day life. I want to thank Discus Agile, Saket Bansal, PRD for giving me this lovely opportunity to speak in front of such a lovely audience. And what else to say? Let me start with this. This topic is not just a topic which I am putting here for the sake of keynote or for this conference. This is a topic of my research. I am working on my day-to-day based coaching on the same topic. In this today's presentation, Saket, I am starting around 10:30, so I will take my sweet time. And if I am not able to continue to finish, then I will continue later after all. Because I want to learn here and want you people to continue the same in your workplace, at your workplace. So, one more disclaimer I want to put before this, that these are the people, I know many of you must be knowing them. Whether it's Dean Liffingwell, whether it's Claire Larman, Mike Cohen. This is not just whatever I'm telling now is in vague. I used to talk to them. I am in continuous discussion with this for this topic, and I have a buy-in from them. So let's come to this topic. Like, what is sprint has to? Why I figured out sprint here in this, like creativity, innovation, and sprint. How many of you? Okay, let me just judge. Can you all please stand up for a while?
Map our further talk. It's not just my talk, it's all your talk also.
So we can map that. Then you start thinking on that part, right? So what creativity means? Creativity means to you?
Something different from the others.
Right. Something new that doesn't exist.
That doesn't exist, something very new.
Looking out for some unforeseen opportunities in our day.
Exactly. Looking for some unforeseen objective, which is not yet here in this world, right? Or maybe it's there, but we are looking out for it. We want to look out for that, right? What I have, this is the wiki definition again, unleashing the potential of your mind to create new ideas, isn't it? That what I feel. Everybody is creative in their own way, but we need to unleash that, isn't it? And now I will bring my this innovation and creativity towards our way of working. How to bring creativity and innovation in our current sprint? Anyone please? How you can bring it? Definitely we all get bored of. Who is anyone who is not yet bored of that in the room? Because this I'm daily basis, I'm working very closely with the team. And this is the very common problem which I'm listening from my team members. I'm not talking about managers, I'm not talking about anybody else. When I'm talking about team means Scrum team, core development team, tester, designer, UI people. So how we can bring it? Any idea?
Before production, we used to schedule one innovation sprint for 3 weeks to 4 weeks.
Before, you said for innovation sprint for 3 weeks to 4 weeks,
yeah,
right?
For completing 3 weeks, we will plan for innovation sprint.
So that you can bring up the innovation.
What I think is?
Hackathon, the idea is to conduct something like value stream mapping. So in the model, improve the process step by step.
But anyway, you are working inside the sprint, right? And you have to follow that sprint thing, what Scrum guide mentions to you, right? We cannot move away from that, otherwise we are losing the value of the Scrum.
So what we do that, we try to ensure that people are thinking. And instead of following, say, the events, three events in a zombie manner, people are thinking across it. So if we start following the same thing again and again, we start feeling bored. And we stop thinking, we just for sake of joining the...
I'm coming to that. Means you are working on the code, I can easily make it out, right? What you are saying, you are feeling bored, right?
I mean, the thing is...
Creativity and innovation is part of your life. It should be day-to-day, it should come.
It should not come out, it shouldn't be. That's my thing.
Yeah.
We cannot bring it through planning, right? It shouldn't be like this. We have user story one, then we have a user story which is like on for the innovation, let's plan for it. Can we?
No.
Right? We cannot. Then we have another user story of creativity, because creativity needs something new, more in deep, and we can plan for 13 story points and let's start working for 2 weeks. Can we do in that way? No. Right? This is not a good way. This is really useless. Not at all useful, and at least we cannot do work in this way. Why? Yes, you said Arshia. Because we are human beings, right? It's not that we have an injection of any drug and all of a sudden new ideas will come up and we are like more innovative, more creative, nothing like that will happen, right? Any human factor which you think? We are not cyber also, right? Many Hollywood and Bollywood movies are coming up with this thing. Like all of a sudden, Rajinikanth have a hero. I don't remember that Shah Rukh Khan movie is also there, right? They have done nice from like comparison. Shah Rukh Khan, Kareena Kapoor was there. They have
very
Ram. I don't exactly remember, but it came into my mind. It cannot be happened, right? We all are human beings. If we have, we need certain time for that. Inside our sprint, and that's what we are looking for. Being human, I heard this word recently, a very nice, I think everyone or who said, human being and human doing. Very different. Being human is entirely different. What we have come up with this process, we all become human doing. We let that being part aside. My manager, my whosoever working upon me, They want us to be more doing. We lost this human being factor. Anyone has heard about this blessing worker in the room?
It's not actual drug.
Exactly. It's not a drug. It's all about the effect of human brain hormones when we introduce something to a human brain. It's all about that. So I'm not talking that I'm going to tell you some ineffective and fake treatment here. It's not at all like that. I'm talking here about like if a human being himself thinks like this will work, then the things work, and it's been scientifically proved with this placebo effect. Many cancerous related diseases also got treated. Because it's a human brain, it's a human thing. If I think this will work. At least the chances of success are more on that. Now come back to our process, human being, doing, and then software development, because at the end of the day, in my feedback, you people will write like what I learned after this keynote, right? So let's come back to this one. Software development process is this. As soon as we talk about process, this is the definition, and better planning and management is there. This is a wiki definition of software process development. And as soon as, since we are in Agile, as soon as we talk about more on the process, this comes to your mind, isn't it? Believe me, when Vibhu was collecting those sheets, people rewrote continuous integration, defects and all. Those are like one level down. Those are the practices, right? Those are the practices. We immediately start thinking on these parts. We are way forward. In general, we generally consider agile software development as a silver bullet for all our problems, right? But what we forget again? Anyone? Human touch. Processes are made for humans. Processes are made for humans. Humans are not made for the processes. What is happening in our real culture? Processes are already there. Right? We are just dumbed down to those processes, and we need to adopt for as per that process, right? Nobody is worrying about what we are thinking. Just feel this. They forget about that. That it's a human factor. We are intellectual people. We are knowledge workers. We are not just the manufacturing machines. They have conveyor belt. It will put cap. It will put a sticker. As soon as it moves next round, somebody will put this. It's not like that, right? We are tired. We have certain problems. My daughter is sick. I cannot work today, right? In that time, what we always been expected from others? Velocity. Isn't it? And that kills our innovation and all. When we talk about car driving and all, we always blame the driver. We always concentrate on the driver. But as soon as we move to software industry, software world culture, it all depends upon the process part. Process is not good. We forget about the human factor of that. So how we hold the scissor doesn't matter. What matters is whether we can use it or not. Getting my point here? It's related to the process. Scissor is that process. Right? Let's take a quiz. What's common here? See, I want to make one statement here. Whatever I'm telling, my today's talk is why is more emphasized, then I will tell you about what and how. Okay? So last few slides will be about what and how. I want you people to think more on the why part. Because it's not like I'm giving you one drug and you just go back to your office and start working. I don't want that. I want you people, your thought process, like you know, your brain cells to start think. What's the common with these? Celebrating success of human. Second thing? Exactly. What I need to see here is every 4 years this is happening. World Cup football, cricket, and the third one. Right? What if these events after 4 years of interval, what if they happen every year? Forget about year, month, then days. What will happen?
We lose
importance. We will lose interest, right? Same thing is happening with our sprints also. As soon as new thing comes, team is very excited, okay, we will do. After a certain time, they lose interest on that part. JP, agree?
Okay.
What? It becomes monotonous. Same thing is happening with us also, right? Everything is becoming monotonous for us. A sprint. One sprint is start, a sprint planning. Then guys.
Diminishing marginal utility.
The more
you do certain thing, the less interested you are towards that.
Exactly. Yeah. We
don't get more of the club, even though it's from the same time
again and again. I do get. Sometimes, honestly speaking, I feel like Bhagwan is so bandaro. Ye roj morning ka alarm, I don't want that. We don't have control on that, that's why we are expecting. We don't have control on time, guys. If you would have control on time, believe me, nobody wants to become adult. That's my answer to that question, right? Agree?
Yeah. I think it depends on the passion. If I am passionate towards something, I will do it again and again on a daily basis. Most of the time, I will be thinking about that only. So I may not get bored.
That passion, right? But if I impose that passion in the form of process, will you be agree with me? That imposing, passion comes from inside, right? Nobody impose your passion on you.
But if there's sufficient buy-in and I'm consulted when a process is being defined, if I am buying into that process, I'm becoming passionate about the process for that.
Then I am coming to that.
Why can't you do this daily?
If I ask you to brush daily your teeth in the night, before sleep, believe me, forget about it. We are enough mature. Ask your kid whether he loves to do it or not. Right? I like it. Habit. Making habit. Going to gym is a very good thing. How many of you go to gym? How many of you do yoga? It's very good. Actually, I can imagine you should. Like, you are from that background. So, no surprises. But I get that, honestly speaking. I always need a push to go to gym, right? So habit saying, let's have this as a habit is easier to say than do. Monotonous way of working would be boring. It lacks creative thinking. It's have like, you start thinking on new things, lack of satisfaction, impacts mental well-being. So these are the side effects of that, the monotonous, right? Consider this. Time, right? Someone said time, like we want to stick to the time. How is like life without weekends? Those who say yes, believe me, I'm going to come to your home. Make sure to send you office on a daily basis. Life with only one type of weather. Nobody can like, right? Driving on the road, same road all the time. Very boring. Being at the same place all your life, most boring thing for me. And now don't ask me that I have to spend my whole life with my wife. Boring, right? No, I'm not going to accept that. That cannot be changed. It's still in Indian culture. Let's still go on, right? Let's come back to our agile world. Let's discuss about the sprint. Everybody is aware of this figure, right?
What point do you want to make that? I understand it's boring. So what is that point you want to make it?
Let me finish. I will take your question in the last. Because your question's answer is in my slides. I want you to realize innovation and creativity. What I mean to say here is why your sprints are human bored. That's what I want to interview. Same plan to act, right? Adapt. So why and how do we change it? because we want improvement, we are looking for innovation, we are looking for the creativity, right? Or there's many this type of quotation you will get, and that proves that we want to improve, we want to change, we want some creativity, we want certain innovation in our day-to-day life so that our life don't become mysterious and boring, right? Same thing, why I'm talking about all these things, again I'm saying it. Because I want you people in your work space to bring innovation there. What these organizations are doing? In their work, they are introducing, they are giving you flexibility of 20% of their time for innovations. How many of you are in your company is having that flexibility here in India? No one, see, not even a single hand. Atlassian, how many of you are using Jira? See, but have you ever found any scope inside the Jira tool where they have written anything for the innovation and creativity, though they are following in their team? Means what they are saying, they are not doing, or they are not implementing in their product. Try to understand. See the importance of that. This is very controversial part. This is not just like I don't want to take the name, but it's the hardcore truth. My client with whom I am working, they have thousands of questions and whose answers I'm still finding out in terms of ROI, because they are looking for all the tangible things. They are not at all looking for intangible benefits. And I used to tell them this. Agree?
Now Google is also taking this away.
I was expecting this question. I was expecting, because I know that. You notice that Google has stopped that. Do you know what Google has initiated in place? No. See, this is the point. Definitely they would have got something better than this. We need to check it out. But at least they got this 4-5 points, right? Just not to start anything new, we are saying Google has stopped that.
No, I'm
not taking your part. This question was expected questions to me. That's why I'm answering it. And it's good, I want to thank you, because that was my second line. Though they have stopped doing, but at least they got 3 or 4 very big products, their base, right? I am also ready to stop after getting 4 of very good 9 money-making features with my current team, right? We should be ready for that. Guys, you would definitely ask me, just have patience. I'm telling you the solution, what they actually need to do, because whatever I'm talking now is a form of an experiment which I'm trying to conduct. And I want you people also, by understanding these slides, I don't remember how many slides are there, but by understanding the gist of the requirement, you just understand the need and the requirement of that, so that most of you are coaches here and 10%, 20% people are doing coding. So they understand the pain, and the other people, those who are managers and coaches, I want them to take this back to your office and do it. Life is an experiment. The more experiment you make, better. It helps us in decision making part, right? The more we do the experiment, I am from research background. I did my research for a year and a half. I know every time when we do research, honestly speaking, success rate is very less. But as Edison said, when you fail 10,000 times, it's not that you fail 10,000 times. You learn 10,000 more reasons that why it didn't work. Quote my points, note my words. When you are going back to your office and when you are trying to implement the things which I am going to suggest further, many a times it will fail, but you never know on what you will get the success. One experiment failed for my one of the client, but it was a drastic success for my second client. So if you are getting a failure, don't just stop there. So I am telling you about some experiment which I am doing. I don't know how you people will do, whether you people see, when you have any of you visited any labs, operational labs, what you feel is most important thing about those labs?
Curiosity.
Practical ones?
Number of iterations.
Iterations, exactly. The prize you give, right? What I always feel is the environment. All the conditions which are required to make my reaction success. Many a time you just mix two reactants and wait for the response, you won't get that. Unless you put certain conditions, right? Certain temperature, UV lights and all those things. Certain like high, very low temperature there. Environment plays a very important role for any experiment to get success. Because reactants are known to us that if we mix this and we mix this, we will get this, right? Only thing is, in any experiment, we need to provide that environment. And I believe that you people will provide that environment when you are going to do experiment to bring about innovation and creativity in your current sprint. That faith I am having with you. And that's why I'm speaking on this topic here. Though I have been working for years and years on the same. First solution, theme-based sprints. Anyone? Nowadays, earlier we have marriages like, you know, go, put the garland, have piras, and marriages are done, right? Very boring kind of people, people are fed up of. Now you have seen that there are themed marriages, right? Why that theme?
Innovation.
Creativity. Because people are bored of that, right? Now people are having marriages, ring ceremony in the air, in the water, and wherever they want, right? I have seen many things. It's all about human, guys. It's all about human factor. Why we forget this to bring in our real life? We are spending 9 hours in a day in office, right? Why we are not implementing? So what I need to say here is, I know this will be a very challenging buy-in from manager. But you have to convince them. You have to do your own research. If you are not able to, just call me, take my number, take my Twitter handle, or whatever you want to connect me. I'm a very available person. Okay.
So there is a point, if you work in a service company, client or the business person, they come and sit on your head, I want delivery. Then with your team or something.
Exactly.
So they want, if your team is already under pressure to delivery, they want the best to be there, they want the coordinate to deliver, feature it, deliver on time. Once you get delivered, you get the ROI. Without ROI, you can't do innovation at all.
Right, very nice. This was again an expected question to me because I'm currently working with a service organization. And there. So you need to explain them the benefit of it. You need to talk to the client's client. Like if I'm working for a client, you need to talk to the client. Even the same thing happens with me. When I asked my manager, he was totally envy of that. Then I said, see, if you are, he always put forward the his client in front and he says, yeah, they are not agree and they will ask me and what, I cannot take the name, but they are big service industry in India. Then I directly talk to client's client and I convince them what intangible benefit you will get after introducing. So, theme this sprint, you can have, see, these are the things we all, how many of you agree with me are very much required, are necessary things for our codes? But they generally take the back seat because it doesn't directly impact the end user in the functionality. Your answer, right? Because our end users are not convinced with this. We need to put forward, we need to show them. When we go to doctor and he tells you that daily you have to take injection, first attempt is yes, sir, please give some medicine, I don't want to go for the injection. Then he used to say, no Jaya, if you go for injection, these and these and these benefits you are going to get, right? So it's our duty and you need to think, I'm not prescribing these things, right?
No, Jaya, all of these non-functional kind of things, I mean, in the safe model, any of this, you have 5 prints for refactoring, you know, after several product improvements, you have those in the framework itself, right? As part of the process itself. So where does innovation come in?
Safe is not getting implemented.
See, I had a talk with Dean Lefkowitz directly. I asked him, you put this innovation. Why you wrote innovation and planning there? I asked, how many of you do really do refactoring after four sprints? And raise your hand. How many of your teams do that?
You need four after four sprints.
Exactly. This is the answer for that. Again, we are making even innovation and creativity as a process. Right? So he said a like long discussion on that. So we cannot, again we are making that as a process, right? So I'm not going to give you any key for that law. I want you people to think about that, try to understand, try to figure out, because whatever I will prescribe, again I'm talking from my environment, right? I will talk from my environment. You need to figure out what will work at your local environment.
Think about the company who is struggling. Think about the company who is struggling and they would like to adopt Agile now and they think that Agile is going to give them benefit faster delivery, faster time to market, faster rate of investment. Now think about that perspective. They want an immediate drug or an injection so that they can come on track. And if you talk about it, you should say, boss, what are you talking about?
See, let me tell me. Security is not an important aspect.
It's
whatever the
important, I would say.
I would
say. No product,
right?
You are not going to buy any product that is not secure.
Not secure.
Very good, very good.
So whatever we are, I have listed out is the ultimate need of the client. So you need to convince them, that's why I'm telling you. Use your brain power. You need to tell them that these are the things which is not like going for shopping kind of. This will result you for a better product. And we want, see, in the name of process, in the name of this agile, and in the name of Scrum, sprints and all, somewhere everything gets lost, right? So I want to bring them back. That is my initiative.
I was thinking these are part of DoD for my teams. So definition of
definition.
Done. When you say it is done,
they are default.
When the automation test has been done, the TDD we are following, that security testing has been done.
Security is the part of requirement, but in the side when we are just following the, can we do it in a theme district? Let's have a innovation. What innovation you can bring is, let's all the team member work on this security part. Let all of them think from that perspective. Let all together work just on the security for a single sprint. Just come to the next slide.
That makes
okay.
It a waterfall.
That will make no, no, I'm not talking about that. Just see this.
Yeah, isn't it going back to waterfall giving the fancy?
Yeah,
fancy.
I mean once. Complete theme for one product.
No,
product
no, I'm not talking
security.
About one product, one complete thing for the one product. What I'm talking about is just one sprint, 1 week sprint, dedicated sprint for these works. This is a single kind of innovation, what I'm telling you. Yeah.
Why should we think of security as something outside what I'm doing on day?
Exactly.
When I check in every line of code, I should be concerned with everything that was there on the previous slide.
Where it's placed. What I am saying is, security anyway you are taking care in your 2 week sprint, right? What happened in 2 week sprint is, that is very tightly packed 2 week sprint. When you talk about your developer, just go back and talk. When they talk about the security part and all, just in the pressure of 2 week sprint, they just give away the things. They just don't dive deep into the security part. So what my plan is, introduce certain theme sprint inside your normal going sprint so that people start more thinking on that, more innovation on that. When you are talking about your regular work, means you are confining them for the current work. I want them to think from the security perspective with not just for the current work but from the all over. In the current sprint, they will just look for the security part of that current story. Isn't it?
We have done it practically actually, the API testing part. I was working with a startup company where we were building a travel portal for them. So it was very important for us to evaluate whether the APIs from Amadeus or Galileo is meeting all the major functionalities which are required by the client. So we did the testing, but it was not like minor parts were also tested. Only the major functionalities, major APIs were tested within a week's time, and then we published a report to the customer and we got that project
belongs. See, what the deep research you don't get chance to deep dive into that part. Right? Let's take the example of this one. Evaluation of third-party API libraries and plugins. Many a times what I saw with my team is they can purchase those plugins that will be much cheaper, but they don't have an idea whether that is available in the market or not. So analysis phase is very less in 2 week sprint, right? So for that purpose, if we can introduce this in the name of innovation and in the name of creativity, if we can introduce these theme-based sprint, then probably we can at least bring up certain deep interest knowledge for our developers.
For innovation, this kind of a sprint, we'll again be going back, like probably we'll have only one sprint wherein we'll do the innovation. So yeah. Doesn't it, you know, again go back?
Yeah. Earlier in my slides, I was not thinking to produce this part. I want you, don't just think of our automation testing or the security or the part, right? What I need to say here is, go and discuss with your team, what area they are struggling more, where we can bring the innovation, whether they want certain time inside the sprint. I'm not saying you just introduce automation because already you are doing. Only thing.
We don't have automation, like having a theme based sprint where you know that the entire team will focus on that theme and try to come up with the innovative ideas. So we are again restricting them to a particular sprint there, right?
I have an answer for that. Theme you can choose, right? I'm not compelling you to choose this theme or that theme. And that theme will be remaining there just for the 1 week. Who stopped you to choose another theme for the next theme to be this?
I'm not worried about the theme. I'm worried about
the sprint. No. There won't be any working product after that sprint because people have worked only on
that. That's the new culture. That's the new thing. That's the innovation and creativity what I'm talking about, you guys. This is the thing which I'm looking for the team. I want them to know that regular going is sprint. Try to introduce. See, if you will go, we want to do innovation, we want to do creativity, nobody will allow. So I'm just giving a thought process which I am introducing. In my team, you just go back, you introduce your own thing. Just get a buy-in for theme-based sprint. Just get a buy-in for unplanned sprint. Yeah.
I agree.
What happened with IP sprint of SAFE, generally that become, like they left as soon as they got, okay, automation testing, we are going to follow that sprint, they stop automation testing in their current work. That's why what I am saying is, have unplanned things for this. Just don't have a planned one. I'm not prescribing, I hate prescriptive model. This is just an example I'm giving you here. You can have your own example there in your life, because what Deepak raised the point, it happens. With IP sprint, same thing has happened. People just, they were accumulating their backlog based on that theme and then they started. Like suppose I made a team documentation team. Theme will be documentation. Then what other engineers started doing in, you know, they just left all the documentation part aside. They said in that theme we will do. So that, you need to tell it to them, see this is the theme page is different, but we have to do whatever currently we are doing in current sprint, we need to figure out one more sprint where we are doing more innovation, more in depth of that part.
And what is the takeaway after the sprint? The takeaway is the implementation of the remaining sprints. What is the takeaway?
Takeaway will be the theme, whatever work you are doing, yeah. That new work, whether you put more energy, more time on the respective topic. Suppose you have the security team, right? You have the automation team. So whatever stories you have done, last, I'm not talking about just the current sprint work.
Sure.
Long back.
Yeah.
So security about all the sprints got finished,
yes.
What all work you have completed, what got left because of the two-week tight sprint. Many of the things got left.
Sure.
Many of the time, teams are not talking about non-functional requirements and they don't want to bring those non-functional requirements in DoD. then just leave, because they say no, we are tightly bound in DoD part, we are tightly bound in 2 week sprint, so we cannot complete all these DoDs for all of our stories in the 2 week sprint. So avoid that part.
Is this
there are 2 more minutes.
Okay, we will catch up. It's not like agreement or disagreement. If you are disagree, we can put the disagreement, all the disagreement in the parking lot. Because again, I'm saying this is a research topic. See, this is a paper. This is a paper in my hand where I have written about the sprints. No changes are made that would endanger the sprint goal. I'm expecting these questions. Because the Scrum Gear Guide tells this about the sprint. That is the figure. What you are saying, guys?
Take out the hero story, you can talk about it, but you cannot talk about the DoD. Because you are saying I can take those things, something you cannot be taking for the time, but you can take the next sprint, please not doing one time.
Guys, I tell you. That's why this is a research topic. I have put a disclaimer in the top, like in the initial slides, that these are the 3 points which the Scrum Guide mentioned that Scrum should follow, right? For the sprint. No changes are made to that, no changes are made that would endanger the sprint goal. Quality goals do not decrease. Scope clarification negotiation by PO and development team is as more is learned. That negotiation is required, right? Scrum, I'm taking this third point of Scrum Guide. Just go back. Just renegotiate with your product owner, with your team, with your customer, with your client, and talk and tell them the benefit of this part. Can we do in this way rather than avoiding them, putting them in the back? Can we try it? Just try it out. Yeah. Shall I finish and then probably you do? I remember faces very well. I'll take you more because I'm looking for the questions, you know. That is giving material for my further research. So I'm not avoiding you. I want to respect the time because I want them to. Okay. So, guys, whatever you are saying. Okay, let me finish the slide. So, unplanned sprint is another initiative which I have introduced with my team. Like having the product backlog, just give the relief to the team and ask them whatever. This is the manager-driven solution which I brought in. They said, no, Jaya, we want something from the product backlog. So I initiated this one, that unplanned sprint, no planning will be there, and just pick up certain things. Tell us what you are going to give away, the takeaway part, what he said. They need to tell. Then see, a sprint team is free to choose items from the backlog. How and what they do with the backlog team is completely up to team. Breaking backlog items into smaller one, prototyping, just go through this, okay? Slide share, I will put all the slides in that. Use your own creativity. All the questions what you raised till now, this is the answer for them. I am very against of prescriptive model. Agile is struggling not because agile is bad, because people are making it prescriptive. Scrum is still in a good shape because it's following the empirical approach. So follow your own creativity. Try to bring your own thing,
right?
See, that's why I said, take the buy-in from your product owner for this. Take the buy-in from your product, talk to the team. That's why I'm saying, see, this is the problem what we are facing in our current system. Correct way of doing. I want to take you all to the next, this type of sprint. Where you can take it, have the liberty of that. See, I have mentioned that every team and team member will work on achieving the goal. At the end of the sprint, showcase what team has achieved. Someone has asked me, right? This is the answer for maximum of your questions. This is not what you all said is new to me. Everybody, whenever I'm proposing this, every company where I work, I got this kind of questions. And we need to find the purpose towards the improvement of product and services.
How?
Million dollar question. This is the answer of your question.
Million
$1 million question.
No, actually, yeah, I want to add one point with regards to the practical project which we were doing. I just want to differentiate the creativity and innovation. We cannot stop our thoughts. And everything we think may lead to some creativity. So I'll give you one example. We were making an application where, you know, the requirement was like, once you select the region, then the area should populate, and then based on the area, then you select your state cities. So there was one creative idea. Why can't we just select the city and make populate all the other fields so that users don't have to spend all the time? So this is a continuous process. Every functionality, start thinking about it differently. And when we are trying to deliver things faster, we leave a lot of technical baggage, technical work. And we never get time to catch up on that. So these team-based sprints,
I think that was
so
creativity on the product, not on the...
Okay, guys, let me close this thing and let me finish it off. Otherwise, again, I will go back with my point, which I want to discuss with you.
Actually, the good idea was it's great that you're getting into a discussion.
Exactly.
Then it would be the right place for that.
See, guys, what I'm saying, not Twitter. I'm physically available here till lunch. You can directly talk to me and discuss to me. Okay. And what I mean to say here is that this chaos, whatever the discussion is going on, actually is the menu for my talk. This kind of doubt is there within you, every one of you, and I want a solution for this through these two ways I have explained, many more, where programming can be a thing, right? On a daily, day-to-day basis of a sprint, you cannot do, but where programming can be one option for that. That kind of initiative you need to figure out, right? So guys, I want to close my talk telling you that this was an experiment. Whenever something new came in the market, new thing came into the market, I have noted down few points from Henrik Niebuhr. He was doubtful about the stable and the dynamic team. Then he come up with the solution. Ken Schauber, the maker of the Scrum, was in the doubt of daily stand-up meeting, and he asked for putting the chairs. Same time, Robert C. Martin, Uncle Bob, was doubtful about test-driven development, and he flew back to the Ken Beck, and then they did it together. Ron Jeffrey, Henrik Mason, are like doubtful. The same question arises to their mind for estimation and abandoning the estimation. So what I mean to say, the lot, the chaos is created. The more experiment you people will go and do at your current place. My motive is not that. I want to tell you guys, this is the prescribed way of innovation. These are the prescribed way for the creativity go and do. That I don't want. Whatever is coming to you, I let you complete your thing. Try to think more and try to like asking me questions. Just ask your team that question. Are you okay? Are you not okay? If you are looking for something new, how we can implement that, right? We are very poor in that part. Don't forget those values of Scrum, that force, right? Focus, openness, courage, respect, and extreme commitment. I am giving you that my points. Because if you want to bring something new, these kind of questions will pop up much more than this. When you will try to implement this in your real life, right? So, try to get the answer, try to implement, try it out. This is an experiment. I don't mind saying that I may fail. I have failed. I'm accepting. I have failed. And I have said that. I failed with one team and I got success with another team. But I learned with that failure. So, you might also get failed, right? So, I have a very nice Hindi quotation on that. That is... जिन खोजा तिन पाइया गहरे पानी पैट जो गौरा डूबर डरा रहा किनारे पैट. What does that mean is those who search in the deep water, those only get the pearl. And those who are have scaredness, those who are afraid of diving deep, those are very skeptical in their nature. They cannot, they will sit, remain sit in the bank of the river and they will just do their normal course of work. So if you really research on this topic, I'm with you. Let's try together and come up. Because when as soon as you go to your team, ask their presence. frustration level, then you will realize the deep need of this innovation and creativity.